Hello everybody, my name is Nikhil Verma and I'll be teaching you all Indian Financial Services. So today we are going to start with the first module, which is Introduction to Financial Services. We all know how important money is in our lives. So the organizations that are involved in facilitating organized exchange of funds are of utmost importance in this particular era. So what do you exactly mean by financial services? Financial services refers to any services that are being provided in the financial industry or by the financial industry. What is this financial industry? Financial industry is the one that deals with management of money. There are various organizations providing financial services, such as banks, leasing companies, stock brokers, mutual funds, and so on and so forth. So today we are going to first see which are those major financial institutions. The major financial institutions involved are central bank. We all know what a central bank is, right? Central bank for India is RBI. Let's not get into too detail about RBI. The second major financial institution in the financial industry is the retail and commercial banks. These are the banks that we visit on a regular basis. I'll take a few examples and you'll understand what exactly retail and commercial banks are. We have Corporation Bank, Union Bank, Bank of India, State Bank, so on and so forth. The next major financial institution is the internet banks. This is one of the major players in the modern era. Internet banks are those banks that exist virtually. I'll take a few examples. One is the Paytm Bank, and the other one is Airtel Payments Bank. There are multiple other such service providers, but these examples should be enough to explain to you what internet banks are. The next important financial institution is the credit unions. These are famously known in India as cooperatives. Then we have savings and loan associations. These are similar to credit unions. But the main motto of these associations is accepting savings, that is accepting deposits, and facilitating variety of loans. Then the next type of financial institutions are investment banks and companies. There are various banks that look after portfolio management and all those things. Those banks come under this sector. Apart from that, we have brokerage firms, insurance companies, mortgage companies, and many such other institutions that play a major role in the finance industry. Now let us focus on the functions of financial services. The main function of financial service is to facilitate transactions, that is exchange of goods and services. Since we have an organized financial industry or finance industry, we are able to trade smoothly even in the time of pandemics. That is thanks to the finance industry and the services provided by the financial service providing organizations. See, you don't have to carry cash. You might be worried in these days, you know, you'll have to go to ATM, withdraw money, and you know, there is a chance that you might get infected through that ATM if some infected person has gone to the ATM. So what do you want to do? You are better off doing cashless transactions. This can be done with the help of UPI, that is Unified Payment Interface. This is facilitated by the Government of India, and there are various banks, you know, that are using this interface to provide you cashless service. So you visit any vendor these days, you will see they are accepting cashless payments through either Phone Pay or Google Pay or Paytm and many such other services. Sorry. The next important function of financial service is mobilizing savings. Imagine life without these financial organizations. How would it be? Where would you save your money? How would you invest money? It would be difficult, right? You wouldn't have all the avenues that you have right now. The main function of financial service is to facilitate movement of funds. So what happens is, if you save money, if you keep it in your locker, it is not going to grow. It is going to be stagnant. But with the help of these financial institutions, you can now benefit from the savings that you do. You can invest your savings, you can purchase gold, or you can, you know, you can keep it as an FD, or you can just leave it in your savings bank account. So what point I'm making is, because of these financial institutions, because of this organized sector, you have got a variety of options to mobilize your savings. The next important function of financial service is allocating capital funds. You might be thinking, right, what do these institutes do with the money that you save with them? The answer for that is, they help various companies who are looking for capital, and they mobilize your savings and convert it to capital that the other companies need. The next important function of financial service is monitoring managers. That is for fund allocation. There are these portfolio managers who manage your funds. So, one of the important function of financial service is to monitor these fund managers who are allocating your funds for investment. And last but not the least is transforming risk. It is the job of financial experts, the brokers in the stock market, or the portfolio managers. It is their job to reduce the risk involved in investing. In brief, these are the functions of financial services. Let us also understand the features of financial services. Features of financial services are, they are intangible in nature. They are also inseparable. Intangible as in, you cannot touch, or you cannot see, you can only feel the services. You can only experience the services. Inseparable. The services cannot be separated from the product that is offered by the organization. The next feature of financial service is, it is perishable in nature. It's because services do change. What service they are offering right now might not be available after some days, because there'll be an advanced service that might come to you. The terms and conditions of the services will not remain stagnant throughout. They will change. So yes, they are perishable in nature. They are variable. Like I told you, the services that are offered to you might not last long. They will be variable in nature. They'll never be fixed. These services are offered as per the needs of people. As the needs change, the offering changes. During this pandemic, haven't you observed that the deposits, the interest that is being paid on the deposits has been reduced? Yes, it is reduced. And the reason is that the need of the hour tells us the money needs to be flowing in the market, and it shouldn't be saved. It shouldn't be stagnant at one place. And so the government or the RBI wants to motivate people to use that money and make better investment decisions, so that the money flows into the market and doesn't stay at one stagnant position in the form of an FD or balance in your savings bank account, or as investment as recurring deposit, and so on. The financial services are majorly classified into two types. One is asset-based or fund-based services, and the other is fee-based or advisory-based services. What do these mean? Asset-based or fund-based services means here the customer will have to provide funds or assets to the service provider, as in they are going to manage your money on your behalf. And on the other hand, fee-based or advisory-based services are, they are only going to give you consulting services. They are only going to advise you. They are going to help you make decisions, but they are not going to manage your money. Let us understand some of the asset-based or fund-based services. The first is equipment leasing or finance. See, this is the asset-based service where they are going to provide you a facility to lease a particular asset, or they are going to finance a particular asset. The second type is hire purchase or consumer credit. Again, similar to equipment leasing. Even here, if you want to procure an asset, let's say a vehicle or a mobile phone, they are going to provide you a facility of EMI. Or like Flipkart had started a service, which I think they have stopped. I'm not sure if it is still there. Buy now, pay later. You are given a facility to purchase a particular, any particular product from their website, and then you can pay after 30 days. The next is bill discounting. Here they are managing your funds. They are giving you funds on advance basis. Let's say you have a bill which is due on September 1st. Today is August 6th. You are in need of funds and you want immediate finance. You visit a bank and you tell them that, you know, I am in need of funds. Can you please discount this bill? And let's say the bill amounts to 10,000. The bank might pay you 9,500 right now. And then they will keep whatever money they get at the maturity of the bill. So they will keep the 10,000 that they receive on 1st September. But you will be getting 9,500. So this 500 rupees will be their charges to give, to provide you this advance. So again, here they are managing your funds. They are giving, they are lending you funds in advance, and then they are going to recover those funds on the due date. Venture capital, investing into profitable business ventures, startups basically. Then you have housing finance, housing loans, insurance services. Again, they are managing your funds. LIC is the best example. You have GIC as well, Then last is factoring and forfeiting. Moving on, let us understand fee-based advisory services. Fee-based advisory services also are of most importance these days. First is issue management. What do you mean by issue management? Let's say you have started a business a few years ago and now you are planning to go public. You are planning to come up with an IPO. Who's going to manage that? You might not be an expert in managing it. So you will have to procure services of experts. Now, they are not going to manage your funds. They are only going to help you manage your IPO or subsequent issues. And then for providing those services, they are going to charge you a fee. Next, we have portfolio management. Under portfolio management, they are going to manage your money for a particular fee, or they are going to advise you to invest money in certain profitable stocks, and then they are going to charge you a fee for providing those advisory services. Corporate counseling, any kind of corporate counseling will come under this head. It can be legal issues, it can be financing issues, it can be management issues, or so on and so forth. But it won't be provided for free. They are definitely going to charge you something. Next is loan syndication. If you want to understand how can you procure loan in the cheapest and the best way possible, you will have to visit experts to understand what are your avenues to get those, get a loan at a cheaper rate or a cheaper interest rate. That is loan syndication. Again, this is not done for free. They are not only going to advise you, they are also going to assist you get the loan. Then we have mergers and acquisitions. you have studied corporate accounting, so I hope you guys have a fair idea about what are mergers and acquisitions. So let us assume that two companies are trying to merge together and form a new company. Who is going to take care of the legal aspect? Who is going to take care of the entire procedure to start the new company? Yes, there might be someone who's skilled enough to do it, but it is always advisable to get it done from experts that are already performing or providing these services in the industry. So they are going to help you merge and come up with a new firm, but they are going to do it for a fee. Capital restructuring, credit rating, stock broking, and so on are a few more examples of fee-based or advisory services. What is the importance of financial services? First and foremost, savings and investment. We have already discussed it in this video, how important it is, how important role finance industry is playing in our life. You know, they help us, they provide us various avenues to save and then further invest our money to get better returns from our savings. Economic growth of the country, of an individual and of the country simultaneously. Service at right place, right price and right time. This is another important factor of financial service. They provide you right service at the right place at the right time. Protection of customers' interest. Global services, they help you invest globally. They also help you meet short-term, long-term capital requirements. Then insurance companies provide you financial protection. Now that you have understood the basics of financial services, let us understand stages in the development of financial services in India. Stage 1, that is before 1980, there were three major services provided by the finance industry. That is merchant banking, insurance and leasing. When stage 2 began in 1980, there were a variety of services that had, that had just picked up. Few of them that were picked up or added to merchant banking, insurance and leasing are OTC services, that is over-the-counter services. You have mutual funds, factoring, discounting, venture capital, credit rating. And when we got into the stage 3, that is 1991 onwards, that goes hand in hand with LPG. The new financial services that were introduced in stage 3 were new instruments, depository services, dematerialization, online trading, and book building.